हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स वेलकम टू सुनंदाज मैथमेटिक चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी लेसन नंबर 1, रैशनल एंड इरैशनल नंबर्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस, यू मस्ट नो सम ग्रुप्स ऑफ द नंबर्स। द फर्स्ट ग्रुप ऑफ द नंबर्स इज नेचुरल नंबर्स, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 एंड सो ऑन। इन्फिनाइट नंबर्स आर देयर, so group of this number is called natural numbers. It is also called counting numbers because these numbers we are using for counting different things. And one is the least natural number. Sometimes we don't have anything with us, that time we need zero. So if we add zero to natural numbers group, the new group of numbers will form, that is whole numbers. Which numbers are present in this group? All numbers which are present in natural numbers, only add 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. What is the third group of numbers? That is called integers. In integers, 0 is also there. All positive numbers are there and all negative numbers are there. This group of numbers, 0, all positive numbers and all negative numbers is called integers. Now in this lesson, you are going to see rational and irrational numbers. Now what is mean by rational number? Let's see the definition. The numbers of the form m upon n are called rational numbers. Here m and n are integers, but n is not zero. It means what? The numbers which we write in the numerator and denominator form are called rational numbers. Which important condition is there? The denominator should never be zero. So here are some examples of rational number: negative 12 upon 8, negative 5 upon 7, negative 4, 0, 3, 8, 32 upon 3, 67 upon 5. Here you can say here denominator is not there, but whenever denominator is not there, 1 is always there. So 1 is denominator of each and every number. So this is about rational numbers. The numbers which we can write in the form of numerator and denominator is called rational number. Only one important condition is there: denominator should never be zero. So these all numbers are called rational numbers. Now let's turn towards how to show rational numbers on number line. See, here I have drawn one number line. It is like a scale, this side. See, if you observe your scale, you find that it starts with 0 and 10 equal parts are there. The fifth part is little bit bigger. Then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the 10th part, number 1 is there. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth line is little bit bigger. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is our number line. In number line, 0 is in the middle. Right side of 0, all positive numbers are there. And left side of the 0, all negative numbers are there. There are 10 equal parts between 0 to 1. Here one example is given. Show 7 by 3, 2 and negative 2 upon 3 on the number line. First thing, you have to observe the denominator. What is here? 3 is there. It means there are 3 equal parts from 0 to 1. See, here the figure is shown. In the center, 0 is there. Denominator is 3, so we have done 1, 2, 3. 3 equal parts from 0 to 1. After 0, first part, second part, and at the third part, 1 is there. After 1 again, 1, 2, 3. To the third part, 2 is there. Then again, 1, 2, 3. Third part, 3 is there. Same to this side, left side. Only negative numbers are there. So why 3 parts we have taken? Because denominator is 3, so we have to make equal 3 parts from 0 to 1. Now how to show 2 on the number line? It is very simple. Here 0, 1 and 2. Now next number, 7 by 3. Now 7 upon 3, how to show? Here 0 is there. You know, 3 equal parts are there. Let's see which is the 7th part after 0. 1, start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4. Once again count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So at the 7th part, which fraction is there? 7 upon 3. So like this, you show numbers on number line according to the denominator. Now next number, negative 2 upon 3. Already we know there are 3 equal parts from 0 to each number. So after 0, second part. So 1, 2. So here number negative 2 upon 3 is there. Got it? Only the most important thing is that you observe the denominator. And that much part you make, equal parts you make from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Like this, right side all positives and left side all negative numbers. Now let's see practice set 1.1. See here. Show on the number lines following rational numbers. The first example, 3 upon 2, 5 upon 2 and negative 3 upon 2. Now here observe the denominator 2 is there. It means what? There are 2 equal parts from 0 to 1. See here. Here 0, 1, 2. Here 1 will come. Again 1, 2. Here 2. Again 1, 2, 2 equal parts from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and so on. Now, we are to show 3 upon 2. After 0, third part means 3 by 2. Let's start counting. Here 0, 1, first part, second part and this is the third part. So here we can show 3 upon 2 on number line. Next one. 5 upon 2, we have already done 2 equal parts from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3 like this. So after 0, you mark at the 5th part. So you will get number 5 upon 2. Again start here 0, first part, second part, third part, fourth part and 5th part. So here you will get the number 5 upon 2. Got it? 5th part after 0. And we have done equal to 2 parts between 2 numbers, 0 to 1, 2 parts, 1 to 2, 2 parts. Why? Because 2 is the denominator, it means 2 equal parts. Now we are to show negative 3 upon 2. You know it very well. To right side of the 0, all positive numbers are there and left side of the 0, all negative numbers are there. Now we are to show negative 3 upon 2. After 0, to the left side, see the third part, 1, 2 and 3. So here you show number negative 3 upon 2. Clear? Only remember what is the denominator and make equal parts from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and so on. I think so it's clear to everyone. Now let's see the next example. Observe the given numbers. 7 upon 5, negative 2 upon 5 and negative 4 upon 5. Observe the denominator everywhere number 5, 5 and 5. It means you draw the number line and from 0 to 1 you take or you can make 5 equal parts. So here 0, first part, second, third, fourth, fifth. At the fifth part number 1 is there. Again from 1 to 2, 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 at 5th number, write number 2. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here write 3. Same procedure to the left side of 0 for negative numbers. 0 to negative 1, 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 1. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 2. Similarly, go ahead for the next number. Now, which rational number we want to show on number line? 7 upon 5. Already we have done 5 equal parts. Now let's start from 0 to the 7th part. Look at the number line. Here 0 is there. First part, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth and seventh. So here at the 7th part, you can show number 7 upon 5. Clear? Second, negative 2 upon 5. Already we have done 5 equal parts from 0 to 1, 1 to 2. Or 0 to negative 1, 0 to negative 2, 0 to negative 3, like this. So, negative 2 upon 5. After 0, the second part. This is the first, this is the second. So, here you can show negative 2 upon 5. Clear? And then, you want to show negative 4 upon 5 on the number line. Negative means left side of the 0. From 0, take the fourth part to the left side. See here. Here 0 is present, first part, second part, third part and fourth part. So here you can show negative 4 upon 5. Is it clear? Let's see the next example. Negative 5 upon 8 and 11 upon 8. Observe the denominator, 8 is there. So you have to make 8 equal parts from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and so on. Similarly 0 to negative 1, 0 to negative 1 to negative 2, negative 2 to negative 3. How many equal parts? 8 equal parts. So first you do that construction. Draw the number line, take 0 in the middle. Then make 8 equal parts to the 8th part 1. Again from 1. Next 8th part 2, next 8th part 3, like this. We want 8 equal parts between 2 numbers, starting with 0. Now, you want to show 11 upon 8 on number line. So, how you can show? After 0, start counting 11th part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. So here 11 upon 8 you can show. Very simple. Only make equal parts as per the denominator. Then you want to say negative 5 upon 8. So it should come left side of 0, 5th part. See here already we have done 8 equal parts from 0 to each number. Let's see the 5th number, 5th part. First part, second part, third, fourth and fifth. Fifth part. So here you can show negative 5 upon 8. The most important thing you have to remember that observe the fractions and see which number is present at the denominator. And that much equal part you do between two numbers. 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. Similarly, 0 to negative 1, 0 to negative 2, 0 to negative 1, negative 1 to negative 2, negative 2 to negative 3, like this. Let's see the next example, 13 upon 10 and negative 17 upon 10. Here, it is like our scale. If you observe the scale, you can see 10 equal part, the fifth part is little bit bigger. So, do 10 equal parts between two numbers. Here 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. To the 10th part, 1 is there. Again 10 parts. After 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here 2 will come. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here 3 will come to the 10th part. Same procedure to the left side. After 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here negative 1. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here negative 2. If we need more numbers, you can extend this side 10 parts and then give negative 3. Now, which number you want to show on the number line? 13 upon 10. After 0, count 30th part. 13th part. See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So to the 13th part, you show the number 13 upon 10. Then next, negative 7 upon 10. So this number you find to the left side on the number line. So let's count from 0 to left side, which part? 17th part. So see here. Here 0 is there. Go to the left side. 17, negative 17 upon 10 we want to show. So start to count the parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. So here you can show the 17th part, negative 17 upon 10. Always remember, positive numbers are present to the right side of 0 on number line and negative numbers are present to the left side of the 0 on the number line. I think so. Now everyone understood how to show numbers on number lines. Okay, bye bye. Take care. See you in the next video.